Hello friends, welcome back to All About Structural Analysis and Design. So in this particular problem, we will solve a indeterminate beam with the help of Kani's method. So in my previous lectures, I have explained you about slope deflection method and also moment distribution method. So this is the third type of method which we analyze the indeterminate structure. So this is the given beam where both the ends are fixed and the loading pattern is point load and UDL. Okay, so first step remains same to calculate fixed end moments. So I will be sharing the link in the description box of both the playlist, that is of slope deflection method and also moment distribution method. So I request you to go through those both methods and be perfect with those methods, and then easily you can understand this Kani's method. So let's begin with today's video. So first step will be to calculate fixed end moments. Okay, so here E and I is not given the value, so we are not going to consider EI, but I value is changing for each span. So AB is having 1.5i, BC is having 1i, CD is having 2i. And now for the span AB, the point load is not at the center. So the fixed end moments will be W A B square by L square for MF AB, and for MF BA, W A square B by L square. So all these things we have detailed discussion in my both the methods, so that formula is only I'll be applying here for fixed end moments. So MF AB, so MF AB will be anti-clockwise, so therefore minus, so minus W A B square by L square. So where A is 4 meters, B is 2 meters, W is 60, so minus 60 into 4 into 2 square divided by the total length is 6 meters. So this comes out to be minus 26.67 kilonewton meter. Okay, so this is how the first fixed end moment you have to calculate, that will be anti-clockwise here. So now MFBA, MFBA will be clockwise, so it will be positive. So MFBA will be W A square B by L square. So W again same 60, so A is 4, now square it is, so B is 2, so total is 6 meters. So this comes out to be 53.33 kilonewton meter. Okay, so this is the fixed end moments for point loads not acting at the center. So now for the span BC, there is a UDL, so MF BC again will be anti-clockwise, so minus WL square by 12. So this is the formula for UDL. So this will be WA is minus here 20. So length is 3 meters. So 3 square divided by 12. So this comes out to be minus 15 kilonewton meter. Similarly, MF CB, which will be clockwise, that is positive. So it is WL square by 12. So 20 into 3 square divided by 12, which comes out to be positive 15. Kilonewton meter. Okay, so this is the fixed end moment formula for UDL. So now the last span, that is CD, which is having a point load at the center, so the formula again changes for that one. So MF CD, again this is CD, that is anti-clockwise, so the formula will be minus WL by 8. So this is formula for not acting at the center, the point load, and this point load acting at the center, minus WL by 8, that is anti-clockwise. So W is 30, so minus 30 into L is 8 meters, 4 plus 4 divided by 8. So this comes out to be minus 30 kilonewton meter. So similarly, MF DC, that will be positive. So MF DC, so WL by 8, so it is positive 30 kilonewton meter. So this step remains same irrespective of slope deflection method or moment distribution method or Kani's method. So the first step in all these three methods will be to calculate fixed end moments. Then only you can proceed with the other steps. Now the next second step in this particular Kani's method problem is to determine rotation factors. So in moment distribution method, those were called distribution factors. Now in Kani's method, it is known as rotation factors. So table is almost same. Only thing is the formula will change to calculate rotation factors. In moment distribution method also, we had joint, members, stiffness, then summation, stiffness, and then we used to calculate distribution factor, which was only k by sigma k. Now here the rotation factor, it is denoted by Rf, and it is formula given by minus half k by sigma k. So only this minus half will come into picture. Okay, so this you have to remember, otherwise the table is entire completely same. Okay, so only thing is Rf formula will change, rotation factor is equals to minus half k by sigma k. So in this particular problem we had two joints. Why two joints? Because A and D was fixed, so only the joint remaining was B and C. So that's why only two joints we will consider for calculating rotation factors. Now you have to see how many members are coming from joint B and joint C. So there are two members coming from joint B, that is BA and BC, and from C there are two members CB and CD. So those things we have to write down here. So members BA and BC, this is CB and CD. So this will be your members. Now stiffness. So stiffness again in detail we have seen in moment distribution method. So here also it is applied same. So now here in both the cases it is fixed, so there will be no change in the stiffness. All the stiffness for all the members will be same, that is 4EI by L. So for BA the stiffness is 4EI by L, BC it is 4EI by L, CB also it is 4EI by L, and CD also it is 4EI by L. So only when the last support is changing, that is hinge or roller, that time the stiffness will be changed, and it is known as modified Kani's method. Okay, so that we will see in the later video. I'll try to make a video on the where the end support is roller or hinged. So now here in this case, so for BA the I value was 1.5. So 4E into 1.5 I divided by the span was 6 meter. So this comes out to be 1EI. Okay. Next, for BC I value was 1 and L was 3. So 4EI by 3. So this comes out to be 1.33EI. Next, for CB also same, that is a BC span only. So 4EI by 3. So this comes out to be 1.33EI. And for CD, it is 4EI by L again. So I value was 2 and L was 8. So 4E2I divided by 8. So this comes out to be 1EI. So now what you have to do? Summation stiffness you have to do for this. Both the members and one joint, what is the summation of stiffness? So 1 plus 1.33, 2.33 EI, and similarly for C, 1.33 plus 1, 2.33 EI. Okay, so now what you have to do is this K value you have to take 1 divided by 2.33 into half you have to do. Okay, so that comes out to be minus 0.214 minus 0.286. So here also minus 0.286 and minus 0.214. So this is how you have to calculate rotation factors. And one thing you have to remember is the summation of rotation factor for each joint should be minus 0.5. Okay, so these are the small things you have to remember. So once you find out fixed end moments, then you calculate rotation factors, and then comes the Kani's representation. So this figure is known as Kani's representation, where you have to draw the box wherever there is no fixed end. Okay, so here we have to fill now all the details. Okay, so this will be your joint A, so this is your joint B, C, and this is D. So for reference we will write down these things. Now once you draw these figures, you have to write down fixed end moments. So for AB, so this is AB, it was minus 26.67. so for BA, so BA it is 53.33. so like this you have to write down. For BC it was minus 15, CB it was plus 15, CD it was minus 30 and DC it was plus 30. So this is how you have to write down fixed end moments first. Okay. So now once you write down the fixed end moments, then you have to write down the rotation factors. So where rotation factors we have calculated? So the four rotation factors are for BA, BC, CB and CD. So these things you have to write down in the box. So for BA it is minus 0.214. So here you have to write down. So minus 0.214. So for BC it is minus 0.286. So for CB it is again minus 0.286. And for CD it is minus 0.214. So like this way you have to write down rotation factors. Now the very important thing what you have to write is the inside value of the box, and that is nothing but the summation of the fixed end moments at that particular joint. So now what happens? 53.33 minus 15, you will get 38.33. So this we have to write down here. Similarly, 15 minus 30, you will get minus 15. So that should be entered in this particular box. So now it completes all the given data. So now you have to calculate the further values. So there is one simple formula you can say to calculate those values. So it is nothing but rotation factor into summation of fixed end moments at that particular joint plus rotation contributions from far end. So one by one, I will explain how to calculate. So it says rotation factors. So first factor, rotation factor is this minus 0.214 into 38.33 plus rotation contributions from the far end. Rotation contribution from far end means for BA, the far end is A, and for BC, the far end is C. So here there is no value at the first particular iteration. So the far value will be zero. So as per your formula, rotation factor minus 0.214 into the summation of fixed end moments at that particular joint. So here what will happen? Minus 0.214 into 38.33 plus zero. So that formula I'll write down for your reference here. Okay. So the formula is rotation factor into summation of fixed end moments at joint plus far end rotation contribution. So this formula you can remember: rotation factor into summation of fixed end moments at joint plus far end rotation contributions. So now we will see one by one with respect to this formula. So rotation factor is minus 0.214 into 38.33. Far end here everything is zero. So once you do this, you will get here minus 8.20, and that value should be written exactly below this vertical line. Okay. Now for next particular rotation factor, that is minus 0.286, summation of fixed end moment at joint is same, that is 38.33, and the rotation contribution for far end for BC is zero. Here there is no value. So once you do minus 0.286 into 38.33 plus zero, you will get minus 10.96. Okay. So first step of this particular iteration is over for joint B. So now we will move on to joint C. So formula will be same again: rotation factor into summation of fixed end moment at joint, which is C joint, plus far end rotation contribution. So now for here, far end for CB is minus 10.96 and far end for CD is zero because there is no rotation contribution here because it is fixed end. So now once you do the calculation with respect to this formula, that is minus 0.286 into minus 15 minus 10.96, that time you will get 7.42 value, and that should be written here. Similarly, minus 0.214 into minus 15. Now rotation contribution for far end here is minus 10.96. So that value you will get 5.55. I hope you have understood. The far end is here 0, here far end is minus 10.96. So that will be considered and that iteration value will be written here. So now similarly, next iteration you have to go. Again, come back to joint B. So here rotation factor is minus 0.214. Fixed end moments at joint is 38.33. Far end contribution, BA far end is 0, BC far end is 7.42. So minus 0.214 into 38.33 plus 7.42, you will get minus 9.79. So that value should be written here. So similarly, minus 0.286 into 38.33. Far end contribution, that is plus 7.42. So next iteration will be 13.08. So similarly, again for C joint, minus 0.286 into minus 15. The rotation contribution for far end at C is here 0 and the next value is minus 13.08. So minus 0.286 into minus 15 minus 13.08, you will get 8.03. So that should be written here. Similarly, minus 0.214 into minus 15 minus 13.08, you will get 6.01. So two iterations are completed. So now the question will be when to stop the problem. So you have to stop the problem when both the values of iterations are almost same. So here it is changing now all the values. So again, one more iteration is required. So again, same formula. Minus 0.214 into 38.33 plus far end contribution now is 8.03 here and here it is 0. So that's why once you do minus 0.214 into 38.33 plus 8.03, you will get minus 9.92. Okay, next minus 0.286 into 38.33 plus 8.03, you will get minus 13.25. Next iteration for C, minus 0.286 into minus 15 minus 13.25, the rotation contribution from far end here. Okay, here it is 0. So you will get 8.07. Minus 0.214 into minus 15 far end contribution, again minus 13.25. So you will get 6.04. So now if you see, almost the values are matching. So one more iteration we will do and then we can see the difference and stop the problem. So minus 0.214 into 38.33, the far end rotation contribution is 8.07. So minus 9.93. Minus 0.286 into 38.33 plus 8.07, you will get minus 13.27. Here minus 0.286 into minus 15 minus 13.27, rotation contribution from far end. So you'll get 8.08. Next is minus 0.214 into minus 15. The far end contribution is minus 13.27. So therefore it is 6.05. Okay, so now you can see the two values are very similar or almost equal. So therefore you can stop the iterations here. So therefore, it is very important to remember the formula to get the iteration values. So here, these are the final iteration values. Next step, the final step in this particular calculation will be final moment calculations. So once you do the iterations in the Kani's representation, then again one tabular format you have to do, that is final moment calculation, where you will be having the joints, that is A, B, C, D in this particular problem. Then next row will be fixed end moments, that is FEM. Next row will be near end contribution. Next will be far end contribution. And then you have to submit all the things and get the final moment values. So I will tell you how to write down one by one. So here the fixed end moments will be minus 26.67, that is AB, MFAB. MFBA was 53.33. MFBC was minus 15. MFCB plus 15. MFCD minus 30 and MFDC plus 30. So these are your fixed end moments. So now near end contribution you have to write down. So that contribution we'll see from here. So now near end. So AB near end is 0, right? So near end AB. So A is near. So it is zero. And always the formula for near end contribution is 2 into. So 2 into 0 is equals to 0. Next, near end contribution for BA. So this will be BA value, right? So BA. So BA near end contribution is minus 9.93. So the last value, whatever you have done, you have to take it. So 2 into minus 9.93. So this comes out to be minus 19.86. So similarly now the BC. So near end contribution for BC is 13.27. BC. So near end is B. So minus 13.27 into 2. 2 into minus 13.27. So you will get minus 26.54. So now CB value. CB. Okay, CB the near end is 8.08. So 2 into 8.08. So this value you will get 16.16. Next CD. CD value is 6.05. So 2 into 6.05. So you will get 12.1. And DC, the near value is D, it was 0 here. So there is no value here. So it is 2 into 0, that is 0. So now far end contribution, similarly you have to find out. So far end contribution AB, the far end is B. So this is minus 9.93. So you have to write down here minus 9.93. So similarly BA, the far end value is 0. So for BC, the far end is C. So 8.08 here. Then CB, the far end is 13.27. That is minus 13.27. CD the far value is 0, that is D, and DC the far value is C, that is 6.05. So like this way you have to complete this table, and after this you have to submit the thing. So minus 26.67 plus 0 minus 9.93, you will get minus 36.6. Next 53.33 minus 19.86 plus 0, you will get 33.47. Next is minus 15 minus 26.54 plus 8.08 minus 33.46. So almost it is 0 once you submit the things. So 15 plus 16.16 minus 13.27, you will get 17.89. Minus 30 plus 12.1, you will get minus 17.9. And this last value will be 30 plus 0 plus 6.05, 36.05. So these are your final moments in kilonewton meter. So you can write down here the unit kilonewton meter. So this is how you have to calculate final moments. And the same problem we have done with the moment distribution method, that you can check with the answers also. All the answers are same, that is final moment answers. So this is how you have to solve with the Kani's method. So the last step will be to draw the bending moment diagram. So this will be your net bending moment diagram. So the lines with the brown color are with respect to the loading condition. So WAB by L for point load not at the center, PL by 4 which is point load at the center, WL square by 8 which is for UDL, and then these are overlapping or this final moment values what we have calculated. Okay, so like this way you have to join this, and this will be your net bending moment diagram for this particular indeterminate beam. So I hope you have understood this problem completely. If you have liked this video, please like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe All About Structural Analysis and Design, and also press the bell icon for the latest notifications of my videos in civil and structural engineering. Thank you, friends.